Good morning, my dear students. Today we will discuss lesson 2, The Sound of Music by Deborah Coley from your Beehive book. This chapter is actually divided into two parts, and both deal with the aspects of music and the legendary musicians who achieved excellence in their respective fields. First part is about Evelyn Glennie, who in spite of being deaf earned a name in the field of playing the xylophone. And next one is about Bismillah Khan, that we'll discuss in a later video. So, Deborah Coley, an Ottawa-based writer and broadcaster, is also the author of Cario. She has been a member of Writers Union of Canada since 2001. Yes, now, God may have taken her hearing, but He has given her back something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. Someone has commented this about Evelyn. He says that although God took away her hearing power, she was impaired, but He gave her an extraordinary thing, and that was the sense of feeling. She could feel very deeply, far more deeply than the normal people, and that is why she was able to express music so beautifully. So well. She is well-known multi-percussionist. She plays different percussion instruments like xylophone, drums. Hear the story. Students, this part is about a Scottish girl named Evelyn. She was very fond of music and wanted to make it her life. Slowly, Evelyn lost her sense of hearing. It was first noticed when she was 8 years old, but by 11 years she was completely deaf due to nerve damage. She listens to sound without hearing it. Evelyn fought against a physical disability and became a source of inspiration for thousands of disabled persons. She was profoundly deaf. She was 11 years old when it was discovered that she had the hearing disability. Students, she was very determined. She was very determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music. But her teachers discouraged her. It was Ron Forbes who recognized her potential and supported her in achieving her goal. She began by tuning two large drums to different notes. Evelyn could feel the different notes of the drum in her body. She felt the vibration of higher drum from the waist above and the lower drum from the waist down. Later she realized that she could feel the vibrations in every part of her body. This tingle in her skin, her cheekbones, and even in here. She had learned to open her body and mind to the sounds of vibrations. After that, she never looked back. Students, the rest was sheer her determination and hard work. She traveled the United Kingdom with a young orchestra, and by the time she was 16, she had decided to make music her life. She auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of the academy. She gradually left the orchestral work and started giving solo performances. At the end of 3 years' courses, she had received most of top awards. She explains that music flows every part of her body. It tingles in the skin, her cheekbones, and even in her ear. When she plays the xylophone, she can sense the sound passing up the stick into her fingertips. As I have told you earlier, students, in 1991, she was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year award. Apart from the regular concerts, Evelyn gives free concerts in prisons and hospitals. She is shining inspiration for deaf children. She has accomplished more than most people twice her age. She has earned name in orchestra. She has inspired those who are handicapped, made them believe that if Evelyn could do that, why not they? Now we come to know the theme of the story and the message we get from the story. The story of Evelyn Glennie is a motivational story. It inspires all of us to overcome our physical disabilities and achieve our dreams and goals, just like Evelyn did. Students, if we will talk about the characters, In this story, mainly there are two characters. First one is Evelyn, the renowned xylophone player who was deaf but managed to overcome her disability. And next one is Ron Fox, the percussionist who spotted the potential within the young Evelyn and motivated her to play dreams. So, if we will talk about students. So, students, here are the chapter highlights. Evelyn lost her hearing ability at the age of 11, but she started losing it at the age of 8. Evelyn wanted to play xylophone, but she was discouraged by all the other teachers. Ron Forbes encouraged Evelyn to play xylophone, and after that, she never looked back. Later on, she became the most sought-after xylophone player with a hectic international schedule. She claims that music flows throughout her body in the form of vibrations. She was conferred upon by many awards like Soloist of the Year. She kept herself busy with performing for disabled prisoners and for the sick. She was also a great woman of charity. She was an icon, an inspiration and motivation for the disabled. So students, here it was our chapter. I hope you got the chapter. And in later we will discuss the question answer. I will give you some assignments and I will give you extra questions also. Thank you so much, students.